New York's Governor Andrew Cuomo says that daily intensive care unit admissions are going down, possibly a sign that stay-at-home orders are having an effect and the worst may have passed. But he is stressing that the state is losing lives quickly. All of this while other states still haven't hit their peak.
This morning, with more than 500,000 coronavirus cases in the U.S. and growing, New York State may be seeing results after weeks of social distancing and stay-at-home orders. The number of ICU patients falling for the first time since the pandemic began, an encouraging sign.
We are cautiously optimistic that we are slowing the infection rate.
Now, with evidence of a flattening curve in some states, President Trump is looking to create a task force focused on reopening the country.
It's the biggest decision I'll ever make.
Trump saying he'll announce how to move forward early next week.
Say, sir, what metrics you will use to make that decision?
The metrics right here. That's my metric.
But according to a New York Times report, new federal projections warn of a spike in coronavirus infections if shelter-in-place orders were lifted after only 30 days, a second wave likely spiking midsummer.
I would hope that by November we would have things under such control that we could have a real degree of normality.
New York Governor Andrew Cuomo emphasizing the key to reopening America's hardest-hit state will be testing.
It's not enough if you want to reopen on a meaningful scale and reopen quickly. We need an unprecedented mobilization where government can produce these tests in the millions.
Tests like the ones rolling out in Northern California, an antibody study to determine whether people have been exposed without knowing it. These people lining up Friday, waiting to learn their immunity status. This, as so many cities across the country prepare for a surge in patients. U.S. Marines flying into Boston to support authorities and the Massachusetts National Guard. Boston's first field hospital taking its first patients as the city braces for its peak in cases in the next 10 days.
We are about to have a very difficult couple of weeks here in Massachusetts.
The governor of Maryland also warning of tough days ahead.
We are ramping up the curve. This is going to be one of our most dangerous times ever. This weekend and over the next week or so.
And there are more cities adding field hospitals, anticipating a need for beds. This morning in Detroit, a new field hospital as the governor bans residents from driving to each other's homes statewide. With life on hold for millions of Americans, the financial impact increasingly apparent. Long lines at food banks in Pittsburgh and Los Angeles.
We are looking for, you know, the fresh food. I hope it will help for our family.
A seemingly never-ending stretch of cars lined up hours before food banks even open.
It's really tough to see because these are people with families and they don't know where the next meal is going to come from.
But relief is on the way for some Americans. The government saying stimulus checks will be direct deposited as early as Wednesday. And amid the desperation, recovery. In the U.S., nearly 30,000 people have recovered from the virus. 44-year-old Tracy Sengel is one of them. Here she is getting a massive send-off from this South Austin Medical Center after 10 days on a ventilator. And she spoke exclusively with GMA.
Oh, that was awesome. Made me feel very special. I didn't think it was that big of a deal, but they showed me it was.
And there are similar cases around the country. Here in Brooklyn, a heart surgeon returned to work this week to this medical center after recovering from the virus. Eva.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.